Hello everyone and welcome back. Since many of you guys requested more tips in my latest video, I decided to make a 10 tips part 2. So guys, thank you for watching and enjoy. The first tip for today is that you can spot the muzzle fire of the enemy weapon even through walls. So you can shoot through walls if you can spot the enemy, or like in this clip, through the ceiling. While playing push, it's often difficult to take an objective by yourself, but you can make a huge difference just by staying inside the objective and waiting for reinforcements. As you can see right now, we are defending and we expect enemies from the front, but what happens is enemies come from the flank, just one guy, and see how my teammates all change their defensive position, leaving the front undefended. In Day of Infamy, there were many hidden spots. You could break walls and enter the objective from the spot. You could climb inside a building through a broken window, so on and so forth. In Insurgency Sandstorm, there are not many of those hidden spots, but through some knowledge of the map, you can find some by yourself. This is a great example of entering this building without giving away your position. In both Insurgency and Insurgency Sandstorm, standing too close to a wall or any random object in the world can give away your position if there is an enemy on the other side of it, because part of your body or your weapon can clip through it and give away your position, so be aware of that. Molotovs and incendiary grenades are great ways to block a pathway, but if you have to go inside the objective because you're losing it and you don't have any more time to wait, if you're full health, you can run through the Molotov and incendiary, sometimes maybe two times, without dying. So walking to the fire is not a death sentence. I'm not sure I mentioned this in previous tip videos, but there is a modular reload in this game, which means that if you're reloading and you get interrupted for any reason, when you start reloading again, you will start from the point you were left when you were reloading the first time. Usually, when you are climbing an objective in this game or vaulting for any reason, you'll probably be dead if there is an enemy on the other side. But if the enemy is very close to you, you can shoot while vaulting. This can be useful and also can give you an achievement. Using an explosive launcher in this game is very useful to clear out enemies which are camping in good spots. But if the enemy is too close to you, you can't kill him with an explosion because the grenade will not explode. But what you can do is hit the enemy directly with a grenade. If you hit him even in the legs or arms, he will die with one shot. In the game mode like push, it's very important to throw smokes in order to advance safely. But what you want to be aware about, if you're entering an objective through smoke and there is an enemy on the other side, they will always see you before you see them. So my advice is to either throw a grenade before entering or wait for the smoke to clear out if you know there is an enemy on the other side. Last tip is for observers. When you're calling in fire support for your commander, you will be shouting to station what you want, giving away your position to enemies. But by using a gas mask, you will muffle your voice and reduce the chance of being spotted by enemies.
I need explosive artillery right here. Call it in. Station. This is observer. Fire explosive rounds at this location. Over.